Immigration has long been the lifeblood of American discovery. History bears this out. From Einstein's relativity to Musk's reusable rockets, immigrant minds have repeatedly redefined what's achievable. Our labs run on H-1B visas. Our startups depend on OPT extensions. Our greatest breakthroughs often trace back to a graduate student who crossed an ocean with nothing but a laptop and a dream. Today, we embark on a four-part exploration that illuminates the human side of U.S. immigration. Join me in reflecting on what these tales mean for our shared future. Feeling lost in this complex immigration system? The law offices of Chris M. Ingram are here to guide you. We invite you to book a free consultation using the link in the description below. And if you're finding this breakdown helpful, please take a moment to like this video and subscribe to our channel. And let us know in the comments below. What does the future of STEM innovation look like to you? Your engagement helps us bring these incredible stories to light. Our first story begins in Cali, Colombia. At 17, Diana Trujillo fled economic instability, landing in Miami with just $300 and a dictionary. She spoke little English and had no family network. Her first job? Cleaning houses from midnight to dawn to pay for English classes and community college. Those nights, mopping floors, fueled her days mastering calculus. Trujillo transferred to the University of Florida for aerospace engineering. Her talent landed her an internship at NASA's Jet Propulsion Laboratory, JPL. She quickly rose, becoming a mission lead on the Curiosity rover. Her breakthrough moment came on February 18, 2021. As flight director for the Perseverance rover's landing on Mars. Today, she's the lead flight director for the Artemis II mission, helping humanity return to the moon. Her story is a powerful reminder that in STEM, where 33% of engineers are foreign-born, diversity drives discovery. Attorney Chris M. Ingram puts it this way, Diana Trujillo's odyssey from janitor to Mars mission commander is the essence of immigrant triumph. It whispers to every newcomer, your hurdles are launch pads. Chase that cosmic dream. The stars align for those who dare to reach. Stay with us. After a short break, we'll meet Zoran Mamdani, the 34-year-old child of immigrants who just made history as the new mayor of New York City. Before we get to that story, if your own American dream involves a visa, the team at the law offices of Chris M. Ingram can help. Whether you're an engineer, a researcher, or an innovator, you don't have to navigate this complex system alone. Visit breakthroughusa.com and book a free consultation with the law offices of Chris M. Ingram to start your journey today. Our next story is about an immigrant who just took control of the world's most famous city. On November 4th, 2025, in the electric hum of Brooklyn's Paramount Theater, cheers erupted. Zoran Mamdani, the 34-year-old Democratic Socialist from Queens, had clinched victory with 50.4% of the vote. This victory marked history on multiple fronts. Mamdani is New York's first Muslim mayor, its first South Asian descent mayor, and the youngest since 1897. But most crucially, he is the first naturalized immigrant mayor to lead the city in decades. Born in Uganda to Indian parents, Mamdani rose from a housing organizer to a state assembly member. In his victory speech, he declared, "New York will remain a city of immigrants, a city built by immigrants, powered by immigrants, and, as of tonight, led by an immigrant. In a city where immigrants drive 40% of tech startups, Mamdani's win is an economic strategy. his platform explicitly supports expanding H-1B visa pathways and funding STEM scholarships for undocumented youth. Attorney Chris M. Ingram commented on this historic moment. Zoran Mamdani's election is a radiant affirmation of immigrant leadership. From Uganda's shores to New York's skyline, he proves that naturalized voices can helm the greatest cities. To every aspiring leader, your heritage is your strength. Rise, serve, and redefine possibility. Coming up next, a quiet policy change that just put a $1,000 price tag on humanitarian hope. We just discussed a city opening its arms. But at the same time, a new federal policy is slamming the door shut for some of the world's most vulnerable, and it's already impacting the STEM community. On October 16th, 2025, a quiet but devastating change hit U.S. immigration. A new $1,000 fee for anyone granted parole into the country. This humanitarian lifeline, a tool used by Afghans fleeing the Taliban, Ukrainians escaping war, and Venezuelans dodging economic collapse, is no longer free. This shift, born from H.R. 1's push to fund enforcement through user fees, aims to deter abuse of parole per DHS Undersecretary Kristi Noem. Foreign nationals who wish to stay here must have skin in the game. A 2025 Migration Policy Institute study warns this fee could slash parole grants by 25%. This will hit sectors like engineering, where 35% of advanced roles are filled by immigrants. Attorney Chris M. Ingram had this to say. This $1,000 toll on parole isn't just a fee. It's a blockade on hope for those fleeing peril. We must safeguard the dignity of the displaced, ensuring pathways to safety remain open, not auctioned to the highest bidder. Coming up next, we decode the November 2025 Visa Bulletin to see who gets a glimmer of hope and who is still stuck in a line that stretches for more than a decade. We've seen the personal triumphs and the systemic barriers. But for tens of thousands of STEM professionals already in the U.S., their entire future boils down to one document, released every month. It's the Visa Bulletin, a cryptic ledger of green card availability that feels like decoding an algorithm. In early November 2025, the new bulletin dropped. The big news: USCIS greenlit the dates for filing chart. This is crucial. It means applicants, especially in the EB2, advanced degree, and EB3, skilled worker categories, can submit their final I-485 green card applications now. EB1, extraordinary ability, is current for most, but China and India are backlogged to 2022. And for EB2, both China and India are stuck. Their cutoff date, April 2021 and April 2013, respectively, per final action dates. For skilled workers from India, the EB3 backlog stretches back to August 2013. Attorney Chris M. Ingram reflects on this stasis. This Visa Bulletin's steady hand offers a foothold for dreamers in line, but backlogs remind us, dignity demands faster paths for the innovators sustaining our edge. Let's push for equity in every cutoff. This month's bulletin is a checkpoint, not a finish line. It's a reminder that progress waits for no backlog. As we close this journey, one truth shines clear. America's greatest asset is its people. From dreamers like Diana Trujillo landing rovers on Mars, to leaders like Zoran Mamdani guiding cities forward. The next Einstein, the next Musk, the next Trujillo, they aren't waiting. They are knocking. Thank you for watching. If these stories matter, like, subscribe, and share this video. And if you are on your own journey, visit breakthroughusa.com for your free consultation. Let's keep building together.